figure out what's reinforcing to an individual child. And I think in the beginning, we have to figure out what is actually reinforcing to them right now. But I think it's really important from the beginning to think about what would you like for to be reinforcing for them. And I think for most of us, we want for it to be for there to be a measure of things being socially mediated, that us saying, good job, we want for that to be reinforcing. It isn't necessarily going to be out the gate. So we start with looking and saying, okay, what is reinforcing to them? And this is where you really got to let go of expectation. You got to let go of everything else and observe your child and see what makes your child smile, what makes your child laugh, what makes your child get up and move to the other side of the room, what makes your child come to you, what are the things that are motivating to your child. And of course, this is going to vary so differently based on their age, based on their abilities, and on their individual personalities, that we could take 12 kids and stick them in the same room, and they're going to gravitate towards different things. There may be three kids who all like the pink unicorn, the stuffed pink unicorn, but there's absolutely one child who is not going to like the pink stuffed unicorn. And that's true for all of our kids, but I think it's even more true for our kids on the spectrum, that it isn't what we assume. Because they find different things reinforcing, or they find different things painful, or they find different things boring than what we do. I've said it before, I'll say it again, that our assumption is that play and toys are fun and should be fun for kids on the spectrum. It isn't necessarily. That sometimes it's frightening, sometimes it's boring, sometimes it just, you know, it's just work. It's just work to them. They don't find it exciting.